In this lesson, we will learn the difference between relative and absolute references in Excel. So far, when we've wanted to access a value stored in a cell, we simply type the address of that cell. For example, if we go to cell C5 and we type equals B1 minus C1 and hit enter, we obtain -1. The formula takes the value stored in B1, which is 1, and subtracts from it the value stored in C1, which is 2. Let's see what happens when we copy and paste the contents of C5 into C6. So I select C5, right-click, copy, select C6, right-click, paste. And the resulting value in C6 is -4. Looking at the formula bar, we see that the value stored in C6 is not B1 minus C1, but rather B2 minus C2, which is 1 minus 5. So what if we copy and paste the contents of C5 into E6? Right-click, copy, select, right-click, paste. And we obtain -1.8. If we look at the formula that's stored in E6, we see D2 minus E2, -2 minus -0.2, which gives us -1.8. This occurs because Excel is assuming we want to use relative references. Although we typed B1 minus C1 in cell C5, Excel actually interprets this expression as take the value that is one column to the left and four rows up and subtract from that the value in the same column as C5 and four rows up from C5. When we copy and paste C5 into E6, we're actually copying those instructions. So we go to E6, and the instructions were take the value that is one column to the left and four rows up from the current cell, which is E6, and subtract from that the value that is in the same column as E6, four rows up. Relative referencing can be very useful when you want to execute the same formula many times in a spreadsheet. For example, say you own a bagel shop that sells 5 items and you want to figure out how much profit you made on a particular day. In the Excel spreadsheet shown here, each item sold in the shop is listed in column A. The number of units sold during the day for each item is listed in column B, and the profit per unit sold is listed in column C. For example, 20 medium coffees were sold on that day, and the profit for each medium coffee is $1.50. In column D, we will calculate the total profit made for each item before taxes, and in column E, we will calculate the total profit made for each item after taxes. The tax rate is listed in cell B8. Start with the first item, which is a small coffee. The total pre-tax profit made on the small coffee is the total number of coffees sold, which is stored in B2, times the profit per coffee, which is stored in C2. The formula B2 times C2 actually means the value stored in the cell that is two columns to the left and in the same row as the current cell, times the value that's stored in the cell that's one column to the left and in the same row as the current cell. We would like to use the same formula for all 5 items in the bagel shop. Copy and paste the contents of D2 into D3. A handy shortcut for copying the contents of a cell into another cell is selecting the cell, in this case D2, hit Ctrl-C to copy, then select the cell where you want to paste into, and then type Ctrl-V to paste. The formula in cell D3 is B3 times C3. This formula takes the value that is two cells to the left and in the same row as the current cell and multiplies that value with the value that's stored one cell to the left and in the same row. In this example, we only need to use the formula for 5 items, so copying and pasting the contents of D2 into D3, D4, D5, and D6 would not take very long. But what if we sold 50 items in our bagel shop, or even 100? If that were the case, it would take a very long time to copy and paste the formula for all the items. We can copy and paste much faster by using the fill handle. Select the cell with the formula you'd like to copy. In this case, select D2. Notice that there is a little black square in the lower right corner of the cell. When you place your cursor over the little black square, the cursor will change into a black cross. Hold the left click button while simultaneously dragging the cursor downward. Once you release the left click button, the formula is copied into all selected cells. By default, cell references are relative to the cell containing the formula. So when the formula in D2 was copied to D3, B2 and C2 were changed to B3 and C3. But there are times where we would like the cell address in a formula to remain the same when the formula is copied to another cell. This requires the use of absolute references. For example, let's say that we pay 25% in taxes and want to factor that into our calculation of the total profit per item. The value 0.25, our tax rate, is in cell B8. So let's go to column E and select E2, and we'll type the formula D2 times 1 minus the tax rate, which is in B8, and hit enter. And we can see for small coffee, our total profit after tax is 25% less than our pre-tax profit. So let's copy and paste this formula from E2 into E3. And notice that the profit after taxes is the same as the pre-tax profit. This is because we are still using relative references. When we typed B8 into cell E2, Excel is interpreting this as the value stored in the cell 3 columns to the left and 6 down from E2. When the formula was copied into E3, notice that B8 has changed to B9 because that is the cell that is 3 columns to the left and 6 rows down from the current cell, from E3. If there is no value input into a cell, there is no value in B9, then Excel inserts a 0. So we have D3, which is 30, times 1 minus 0, and we end up getting 30. we want the cell address B8 to remain the same every time the formula is copied to another cell because the tax rate is stored in B8. So we go back to E2 and we can change B8 from a relative reference into an absolute reference by putting dollar signs in front of the column letter and the row number. And when we copy and paste the contents of E2 into E3, we see now that the total after-tax profit is calculated properly. Although D2 has changed to D3, B8 remains the same. Every time the formula is copied to another cell, the value stored in B8 will be used for the tax because we have used an absolute reference. D2 will change to D3, D4, D5, and D6 because we have used a relative reference. Let's look at another example where we use a combination of relative and absolute references. In this worksheet, there are 24 values. In cell E7, type the formula equals A2. This formula is translated as the value 4 columns to the left and 5 rows up from the current cell. The value stored in that cell is 1. If we copy and paste the contents of E7 into F8, the number 7 appears because that is the value 4 columns to the left and 5 rows up from the current cell. That's the value in B3. And the value is different between E7 and F8 because we are using relative references. Go back to cell E7 and type equals $A$2 and hit enter. This formula is translated as equals the value in A2, specifically in A2. So if we copy the formula from E7 and paste it in F8, we also get the value in A2. Now let's go back to cell E7 and type $A and remove the dollar sign in front of the 2. Now this formula is translated as the value in column A 5 rows up from the current cell. So if we copy and paste the formula from E7 into F8, we get a different value. We get 4. We have copied the instructions. Take the value in column A 5 rows up from the current cell. So column A 5 rows up gives us the value in A3. So here we're using an absolute reference on the column letter, but a relative reference on the row number. So let's go back to E7 and type equals A. So we remove the dollar sign and we put the dollar sign in front of 2. Now this is translated by Excel as the value in the second row, 4 columns to the left. So if we copy and paste the formula from E7 to F8, we get 5 because that's the value in the second row, four columns to the left. We can use combinations of relative and absolute references in formulas. Go to cell C7 and type the formula equals $C2 plus $C$3. This formula is translated as get the value in column C, five rows up, and add to that the value in the same column as the current cell, row 3. So if we copy and paste these instructions into D7, we get a different value. We add the value in column C, five rows up. We add to that the value in the same column as the current cell, row 3, so 9 plus 1. If we copy and paste the formula from C7 to C8, we get 4. And that's because we are taking the value in column C, 5 rows up, which is C3, and we're adding to that the value in the same column as the current cell, third row, which also happens to be C3.